You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success. From the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
Hi, this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. Thank you so much for tuning in. I am so excited. Today on Inspired Success, we begin the countdown to the third annual Total Woman Conference. Yes. That's what I said. We begin that countdown today. The third annual Total Woman Conference is on Saturday, April 2nd, 2011, at the Simsbury Inn, 397 Hop Meadow Street in Simsbury, Connecticut. And this year, oh my goodness, we have a power-packed agenda for you. TotalWomanConference.com is the place to visit to learn more. For many of us, many of the viewers, you're familiar with the Total Woman Conference. But for the first time, listener or the person watching for the first time, you're wondering, Total Woman Conference? What is that all about? Well, the Total Woman Conference is a one-day multi-generational conference that I produce under my company, Royal Proclamations, to care for women. I care for women. So blokes, don't touch that dial now, okay? Don't be selfish. Listen through. You probably have a woman in your life, okay? But this time around, we're caring for women. We care for women. And what does the acronym CARE stand for, you may be thinking? Celebrate. We celebrate our uniqueness as women. We applaud the often overlooked achievements and contributions that women make to community development, to business, and to family. We refresh with spa treatments, massage therapists, and cosmetologists. And we equip with dynamic seminars from inspirational speakers who inspire and empower. That is what the Total Woman Conference is all about. A one-day conference to care for women in all spheres of their lives. And today on the show, to begin this countdown to this dynamic conference, I have in the studio with me some dynamite women. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Really, these women are high energy, inspirational, you know, go-getters. And at the same time, you know, they're humble, they're working family women, they're everyday women. I mean, they're just truly an inspiration. The combined experience of every woman in this room, as young looking as they are, is over 100 years. And so blokes, you know, don't touch that dial, I'm telling you, because even from us, even though we're talking women's stuff, I'm really serious that you could learn, you'll be learning some real great nuggets from this broadcast that will really equip you for work-life success. So just get going right away. It is my great honor and privilege to welcome to the studio, to welcome to Inspired Success, the 2011 Woman of Distinction Award recipient in the business category, Miss Lynn Ward. She's the president and CEO of the Waterbury Regional Chamber of Commerce. Seated next to Miss Ward is Mallory Mason. She's an image consultant. This woman, don't let looks fool you, you know? She is really, 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 really very experienced. She knows how to put that woman together, you know, on the outside. And she owns Mallory Mason, an image consulting firm. Please welcome to Inspired Success.
Great, thank you.
And here's my networking partner, Ms. Jodi Ferrer. She's the owner of The Perfect Promotion. So if you're looking to promote your business through nice, creative promotional products, Jodi is the person to talk to. Welcome to Inspired Success. Nanette Bosch is the owner and the founder of BangleAndClutch.com. So go online, BangleAndClutch.com. She also is an author, she's a speaker, and you know, an image consultant as well. Lastly, but definitely not least, oh my God, this woman truly inspires me. She doesn't know that, but she truly inspires me. She epitomizes a total woman, what a total woman is all about. She's got it all together in her business life and in her personal life. She's none other than Miss Lisa Wilson Foley. She's the owner of Where Do I Start From Now? Which one? Blue Fox Entertainment Enterprises, Apple Rehab and Spa, All Star Therapy. Welcome to Inspired Success. We're gonna get into this conversation right away. Ladies, it's your day. It's your day, it's your time to care for you. On Saturday, April 2nd, 2011, at the Simsbury Inn in Simsbury, Connecticut. And our theme this year, you know, I reflect, I meditate, I start to muse, and I usually will come up with a theme for the conference. And this year, I thought about it, and I came up with a theme for the conference as the power for excellence and distinction. The power for excellence and distinction, the principles, the things that will help you to really, truly shine in life. Because I believe, and I don't know whether you would agree with this, that every one of us has an innate desire to truly excel and to shine in life. Would you say so?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yes. But the problem usually, the challenge is, how do we navigate? How do we navigate huge structures? How do we negotiate in the marketplace? How do we go up that corporate ladder? How do we balance everything that we have going on and still really then achieve that dream and achieve that, you know, distinction that we're looking at? So that is the theme of our conference this year, the power for excellence and distinction. And every woman seated here today is involved in one capacity or the other, you know, with the conference. So let's get it going. I mean, we can't really cover a full day's conference here on this show today. So I really encourage you to go to www.totalwomanconference.com to register for the event. But let us really start with you, Lynn, because, you know, you have that, we are giving you that honor and well-deserved honor, absolutely well-deserved. We really kind of checked out her background, and she was like, you know, I'm checking you out too. You know? You're checking me out, I'm checking you out. Who are you guys? Kind of thing. But, you know, checking out your background, you do a phenomenal job through the Chamber for Women. The Business Women's Forum is one of the leading, I think, Women's Day conference in the state, or in the region, actually. And so you do a lot of work for women. Can you just share a little bit more with our viewers how your work impacts women, and a little bit more about your background?
Sure. I've been with the Chamber 25 years
now. Oh, my goodness.
Started there as a bookkeeper and worked my way up. One of the things that I had been involved with for about 20 years of the 25 was the Businesswoman's Forum, first on a volunteer level and then getting involved in the management of it. So that conference is very empowering to working women.
Yes.
So we're thrilled to be able to provide that year after year. This year is our 29th annual conference.
Wow.
One of the other things that we do is we do a leadership program through our Chamber of Commerce, the Waterbury Regional Chamber.
Yes.
We also do healthcare council events that we tend to see the majority of people are women in healthcare. And, you know, it just seems like more and more since I was promoted as president, which was the first woman president in a 125-year organization.
I know.
Now women are more inclined to get involved, get involved more on the leadership level as well, because they feel like they can relate to somebody in that seat, in that leadership seat.
Exactly. Why don't you jump right in, Lisa, because she's talking now about the healthcare industry, which I know is your industry, one of the industries in which you operate in. And, you know, the fact that, you know, a lot of women are in that industry. How does your work there impact women?
There's two things. One is that women are the ones that are providing the care, but sometimes they're the caregivers, but then they don't take care of themselves.
Right.
And then when you look up the hierarchy, you see men at the top overseeing all these women in the professional field. And that's been like that for many, many years. It's starting to change where women are taking on leadership roles in healthcare, but we have a ways to go. And so I think that as an owner of a healthcare company, I do try and empower women. I say, you know, I'm a physical therapist, I'm the owner, I understand what you're going through and what you need, and let's take care of you so that you can take care of your family better. And so I am involved in trying to do what you do on a small scale.
Yes, exactly. And we're going to come to that about this whole care concept, you know, about women, you know, being great caregivers, but really somehow being not so good at taking care of themselves. You know, we're going to be touching on that later. But Nanette, you know, you own an accessories company, online firm, and I'm sure 90% of your clientele are women. Yes. But, you know, how does your business really kind of impact women?
I think that my business impacts women. Well, I know that you could probably speak also to the empowerment, actually, that you feel when you are looking your best.
Yes.
To me, accessories finish the outfit.
Yes.
And a lot of times when you do put yourself together, take the extra time in the morning when you get ready and you go out and meet the world, you are, you know, meeting them with your best face forward. And you end up, I think, drawing a lot of people to you, or you might find yourself getting compliments that maybe you wouldn't have had otherwise. And I think that everyone likes that compliments.
Yes.
So I think that that definitely could make a difference in energizing your day.
Absolutely. And that's the perspective and the philosophy through which I run my coaching and training practice. It's from a holistic perspective, because I think everything is kind of all interconnected, interrelated. Life is integrated, you know. And so it's a spirit, body, mind, soul thing. Everything from the inside to the outside really is kind of connected and really impacts how you your overall how you feel about yourself, how you, you know, are able to carry yourself, and how you're branding yourself, really. And you know, we're going to be touching about that. I know Mallory has a little bit more to chip in with that. And
yes, absolutely. As an image consultant, I think fundamentally where we start with consulting with women is their confidence.
Yes.
And really, you know, taking the emphasis away from their concerns. I think as women, automatically when we look in the mirror, we're, you know, saying we don't like our thighs, or we don't like, you know, we look automatically as what we don't like. So kind of working with them and, you know, going through the process of identifying their body shape and knowing, you know, no matter how much you weigh or how tall or short or, you know, what have you, that you can look great at
yes.
any size. So really, you know, going over camouflage techniques and principles to highlight your assets and then, you know, kind of camouflage the areas that, you know, you're not so fond of. But
yes.
Realizing that everybody, you know, has problem areas and everyone has parts of themselves that, you know, they don't necessarily like or, you know, want to highlight. So, you know, going back again to building up their confidence
yes.
so that they can, you know, kind of dress for success, for lack yeah. of a better term, and feel great about themselves every day.
Absolutely. And this is what this is all about. This is what this entire show is all about. This is what the Total Woman Conference on Saturday, April 2nd, 2011 at the Simsbury Inn is all about. We're meeting you right where you are. You know, as you are, you can be empowered and you can be better. Okay, and we're not saying that everyone is perfect. We're not looking for perfection, but right where you are, as you are, we can come alongside you and really, from the inside out, really help to empower, refresh, rejuvenate, and equip you for work-life success. And then Jody, I know you have a phenomenal company, and you know, you're one of our event partners, and you'll be producing some of our products. And everyone here works with men as well, so just take notes. But we're just highlighting particularly for this show, you know, how your work impacts women.
My business, I would say, you know, in the perfect promotion part of what I do every day, I do work with men and women.
Yes.
I think where I use my business, I utilize my expertise, is really to empower and mentor some
yes.
younger women that work for me.
Yes.
And I even work with a woman who left to go into another area. As a matter of fact, this morning we met for coffee and I was helping her. So I use my business in that way, and also in the nonprofit sector. I work with a lot of women's groups.
Yes.
So, but I can't just pull out, in, you know, for the promotional end of what I yes. do, just
oh,
a women
no.
thing.
No, no, no. And I don't think anybody's work yeah. here, you know, doesn't impact
right.
men and women. We do. But we're yeah. just kind of specially highlighting the way in which, you know, and then we are women. The women seated here. So, mm. you know, we want this women and everybody here to be able to relate to at least one woman here today. And that's one thing that we are very deliberate about at the Total Woman Conference. We're very deliberate about who our speakers are, and in terms of the diversity in their background, in their expertise, and in the industry in which, you know, they operate in, because we want every woman who comes to our event to be able to identify with a woman there and relate to her and take away something from her. So let's dive in now. We know how you work, and we know that you're doing some great, great, phenomenal jobs as women. And, you know, you have personally, everyone here has really have been able to achieve some kind of success. Lynn, you were saying how you kind of grew up through the ranks, really, and just went up like that, literally. What does it take to really get to that level, you know, where you're growing and you're achieving and you get to that level? What does it take, would you say?
A lot of patience and perseverance.
Mm.
And a lot of hard work, but it's the extra work, I believe, is what helped me get to where I am. And, you know, and keeping that balance is, the you know, very difficult to do that, because if you feel that you have to go above and beyond all the time, then you're going to suffer
yes.
at home on the personal level, too. So it is a challenge, but I think that if you strive for the position that you want to be in
yes.
while you're doing a fantastic job in the current position you're in,
yes.
you're going to see doors open for you.
Absolutely.
And that's what happened to me.
Yes, great. And so would you define excellence as going over and beyond the call of duty?
Or what, I do.
How would you, yeah,
I do.
So hard work, hard work, hard work, hard work. We're working at home. We're working. I remember last year's event, and Leslie Bales was the, she holds Griswold. I don't know whether you know of her. And, you know, we were sending emails at around 1 a.m. in the morning. And she was saying, Bala, you know, how cool is this? You know, women, who are the hard workers of the world? You know, I mean, we're up till late doing work, and you're running to take the kids to games. And we are working hard, but still, many, you know, women are still not being able to break through and achieve their dreams or achieve that level in which they're trying to reach, you know. So I do totally agree with you. Hard work, yes. Perseverance, absolutely. No overnight success, you know. But beyond that, what else? Does anybody have anything that you want to add to that?
Passion.
Passion?
That keeps you going. Because if you don't have the passion or that drive, it could get tiring.
Yes.
Mildly.
Yes, yes. So you're just saying, oh, yes, this is the gospel that I preach all the time. You must locate your passion.
Yeah.
You know, we must find a way to connect your work with your passion. Otherwise, like you said, it'll just wear you out. So obviously you enjoy what you do.
Right.
Absolutely, exactly. Otherwise, there won't be the energy to persevere.
Right.
There won't be the strength to keep going on when you read those roadblocks. And so you would say passion, absolutely. So you've got it now, you know. It's the three P's.
Yes.
Did you notice that? Perseverance, you know, passion, and then a lot of, you know, hard work. And anybody else want to add to
that? I think that I would like to add. I think that it's important also to have a great network of support, especially female support. No offense to any male viewers, but as women, it's great to have a really good core group of women that support you, that are the "you can do it, girl." And if you don't have that group, I think that you need to go and get yourself that group, because I really think that that's very important.
Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely. And that old boys club, look, okay? We're going to be on golf course on the first, okay? We're starting our own girls club here. Free conference. I just want to even mention that before I forget, that preceding the conference on Saturday, April 2nd, is a VIP reception for executive women only at the Blue Fox Run in Avon, Connecticut, which is one of the companies that Lisa owns. And we're going to be learning to play golf and, you know, just networking and recharging in a non-threatening manner for VIP women only. It's by invitation. So if you want an invitation to that event, totalwomanconference.com. But absolutely, networking, collaborate, synergize, you know, get together, plug into a network of other powerful women. Absolutely. And what about when you're within a corporate structure? You own many companies. You probably employ maybe 500, 300 total, right, Lisa?
Yeah.
And so what would you say in terms of navigating huge corporate structures and in the workplace? What role does networking and, you know, collaborating and volunteering and letting the CEO know you, see you, being visible, you know, what role does that play in, you know, attaining distinction? And is there anything else you want to share?
Well, I think, you know, my company is still relatively small, and it's 500 employees total when you add up all the different pieces.
Yes.
So we don't have a big corporate structure.
Okay.
And I call it home office, not corporate office, because, you know, I want to keep it simple.
Yes.
I don't want to become too bulky at the top, right? But I think that, you know, volunteering to go that extra effort. I mean, if I take a table at the Girl Scouts breakfast and, you know, you say you want to go, that adds points to your name.
Absolutely.
And so I always want some people to take that extra effort, and that really does help coordination and commitment at the corporate level, at the company level, really helping other people in their jobs. That plays well with me as well. I do want to just mention about what I think sometimes women have a problem with when we talk about, you know, passion is really important and all those things. But I think sometimes we get stuck in perfectionism. And by, you know, being so perfectionist at different places, whether it's at home or at work, we miss out on opportunities because we're so busy getting this one little slice perfect. And I jokingly say, give me the whole messy pie. You know, I want it all, and a little mess is okay.
Yes. Oh, yeah. That's such a great one. And I think it's part of how we're socialized as women, wouldn't you say? Sometimes, you know, this nitpicking, wanting to be perfect, the perfect lady, the way, you know, some of us are kind of being raised. But knowing that, you know, it's okay not to be so perfect.
Yeah.
And, you know, when you become too hyper-focused, like you said, then you miss out on the bigger picture and the little opportunities that may be coming your way. So you've got those principles so far. Being patient, persevere, locate your passion, connect with your passion, network, collaborate, synergize. That is just my own philosophy as well, because, you know, I'm the queen of networking, you know.
Yeah.
And actually, my last show was with a colleague of mine, Kathy McAfee, and she's an author and speaker, and she just wrote a book, Networking Ahead for Business. And you can go and view that broadcast if you really need to get some tips as to how you begin to network. But that is so important in terms of, you know, coming together and synergizing and finding a mentor. You had mentioned that as well. I would want to add that in terms of excellence and distinction, you know, go and undershadow someone. Go and, you know, choose a mentor. And that's why I said, look, I so admire her. She doesn't know that. But looking for someone who represents your possibilities. You know, I was saying jokingly to Lynn, half jokingly, that, you know, that the Business Women's Forum are kind of right behind you, you know, and all of that. But seriously, you know, I think that we need to really now begin to also, you know, have a mentors, you know, professional mentors and all of that, that we can kind of understudy, that can help us and can, you know, help us to navigate. They've been there, and so they know. And wouldn't you say so? that, you know. And why do we find then sometimes that women are hesitant and we want to come to this care issue? Because it's a one-day conference to care for women in all spheres of their life, celebrate the uniqueness of womanhood, applaud the often overlooked achievements and contributions that women make to community development, to business, and to family. And this year, one of our honorees in the business category is none other than Miss Lynn Ward. And in the community development category, we're going to be recognizing Deborah Allman of the YWCA. And in the family category, we're recognizing Miriam Torres of the House of Restoration. And our new state Secretary of State, Denise Merrill, will be at the conference to present the awards. And it's a great networking platform. I mean, you're going to be meeting just a diversity of high energy, inspirational women. So you get out there and invest in your care if there's nobody who wants to do it for you. But now let's talk about that. I find that we are great care providers. You know, whether it's at work, whether it's at home, you know, we are always the one providing care, supporting, nurturing others, encouraging others. Why do women not invest so much in their own personal care? When I say care now, I'm not just talking hygiene or anything like that. I'm talking their professional and personal care. What do you say, Lynn?
Well, I think that there's still only so many hours in a day. And that when you have all the work responsibilities that you have and you have your children or families at home, it is very difficult. And I myself, over the past year, made a conscious effort to schedule actually personal training for myself.
Yes.
And because I was able to schedule it in my day, but I'm fortunate to have that flexibility within my own schedule.
Yes.
So I think that you really need to just make those decisions and then schedule it and actually do it.
Sometimes I think it has to do with sometimes some of the value systems that are going on in place in our lives. We may not be maybe subconscious, because what we don't know, we don't value. And what we don't value, we abuse or misuse or don't use. You know, sometimes I think we don't understand our own value and our own worth, and that we, like L'Oreal said, you're worth it, you know? You know, that we do deserve it. And also that, you know, you can't really give what you don't have. And so at some point, if you don't invest in you, then what is it that you are giving out? But, you know, so what do you would you say as your being your observation? Like, Aline really, really touched on scheduling yourself, putting yourself on the agenda. And so put Saturday, April 2nd, 2011 on the agenda. It's for me. And then if you're an executive woman and you, you know, you want to come on the Friday as well to network and recharge, put that on their calendar as well. Don't say, oh, it's a Saturday, I can't give up my Saturday. It's for you. It's to care for you. But so what have you found? Why are women hesitant?
Actually,
sometimes.
Yeah, I encounter that a lot in my business, because as an image consultant, that's exactly what it is yes. Investing in yourself. I think as women, we have a little bit of a guilt complex when it comes to that.
Yes.
You know, because we feel like our sole priority should be our families, our kids. So they invest all their money in their
yes.
kids. And then the money left over, they don't want to put it into themselves.
Yes.
And, you know, on my emails, my little tagline is, you know, the only guaranteed investment is investing in yourself. I mean, that's one thing that, you know, if you put the money into, you know, you're going to see a return all the time.
So, that's a good one. I like that one.
You know,
one.
I've had clients that, you know, because I do everything from personal shopping to closet audits to color analysis, things like that. And these women wait for things like their birthday, you know,
yes.
to call me and say, Mallory, you know, I'd like you to come over and help me with my wardrobe and things like that. So it's not even in a process of kind of, you know, building up their wardrobe or refining it for their business pursuits. It's, oh, you know, let me take this one day out of the whole year to spoil myself. So
yeah,
this
yeah.
is a conversation that I constantly have with women in particular about, you know, it's worth it, you know.
Exactly.
And there's a long-term effect to it.
Exactly. And I think that is the mind shift that needs to also, we need to change and needs to go on in the minds of many women, is that guilt, that you know, I'm not really worth it, I'm not deserving, I should put myself last. That's the expectation, you know. And while, you know, we're not talking about being selfish and self-absorbed or being self-centered, but we need to really understand that really, we don't, if we don't invest in us, nobody's going to do it. And if we don't invest enough in our care, in applauding ourselves, hey, you know, no one to celebrate you, tell yourself you did a good job. Give yourself a pat on the back, you know. I did great, you know, and own it and refresh yourself. And you have the Apple Rehab and Spa, you know, and they're going to be present at the conference to offer quick massages and things like that. So, but what have you found, you know, either personally or from working your interactions with women, that why, what have you found? Why are they hesitant?
We're just made up of, you know, as being nurturers, and yes, part of that nurturing behavior that we're is just, it just is. I don't think we try to be that, and so we have to take care of our families, our staff, you know, whomever, our neighbors, our friends, and the to-do list is always so long. It's never ending, and do I want to go work out, or do I want to get one more thing checked off of my list? And it's usually the list, although I have to say, like Lynn, I started scheduling a workout for me, and it was on two nights. One was date night, and one was a night I did something with my child, and I decided enough is enough because I was really going to a place that I wasn't comfortable anymore physically. And everybody had to shift,
yes,
and everyone has survived.
Exactly.
And I'm really proud to say that I'm working out, and
great,
that's one of my biggest accomplishments, that I've made that switch. And also, like Mallory said, the guilt factor. So, you know, but we are worth it. And
yes,
if we do have daughters, it's important that we show them that they should be taking care of themselves as well.
Absolutely, absolutely. It's that, you know, investment in belief, in the belief that we really do are worth it. And, you know, Lisa, what have you found personally or with your employees? And then I think sometimes, I want to just quickly touch on that, is that when I look at the employer, most of us here are self-employed, okay? And I think it's really a little bit easier because when you're in control of your schedule, you manage it yourself, and so
not so much. It depends if you're self-employed and you don't have anyone else working for you, or if you don't have, you know, clients that depend on you, unless you make the schedule. I think when you own a business, and I'm sure a couple of the ladies will agree, we work even more than people that are working for others because we're doing the job of the day and then we're going home and
doing the job of the night.
That's right. We don't have a time clock. You know, when I'm in the office, I'm helping my staff. I'm dealing with, you know, this, that, and the other thing, which are all wonderful. But then I have to go home and do my work.
Yeah.
You know, and but we do have that flexibility as being self, you know, having our own companies. We do have that flexibility. But,
yeah, exactly. That's what I was trying to get at, that we do have more flexibility with our schedule. And, you know, we don't necessarily have someone kind of breathing down our neck and saying, this is the absolute deadline. These are the absolute goals you must reach. And I think sometimes for working career women, it's a bit, you know, more difficult, more challenging for them. But, you know, Lisa, you're going to be a panelist at the conference Saturday, April 2nd, 2011 at the Simsbury Inn, totalwomanconference.com. And what you're going to be talking about, now you know, is about being visible, vocal, and viable. And about, you know, the power of negotiation and advocacy, which is more about speaking up for ourselves. Being able to, you know, have our own voice and say, you know what, I've had enough, I've had it, you know, I'm done for the day, that's it, sorry boss, I'm leaving, you know, or I've had it at home and say, you know, I need to take a walk. You know, we somehow are hesitant about being vocal, you know, about being vocal and knowing, having that art to negotiate. And I know that as a woman in business, I mean, you're negotiating across the boardroom with a lot of men and all of that. So, yes, absolutely, yes.
So, I mean, the good thing is they underestimate women. That's rule number one. And use that to your advantage, because you sit across a group of men, and they automatically assume that they have one over you.
Yes.
And, you know, one of the first businesses I bought was a golf course.
Yes.
And I dealt with seven gentlemen, Italian gentlemen in their 70s.
Oh, boy.
And I was pregnant, and I think I was, you know, 34 or whatever, and they totally said, you know, you're going to buy our golf course, you?
With baby.
And I realized that all they needed was a little stroking, and they needed me to start, they felt like, oh, she's like our granddaughter. And as soon as they kind of could relate to me from a granddaughter way, or a daughter way, whichever, I was feeling more like a granddaughter at the time, it changed the whole dynamic of the negotiations. But you have to figure out who you're negotiating with and what their expectations are. And not that you want to manipulate it to a degree, but you want to make sure you're paying attention to your inner voice, your gut feeling.
Yes.
And women have that way over guys.
Yes.
Right?
Yes, we do.
We have a better gut than they do. And
yes.
That's one of our skills. We have other failings we're not going to mention today, but I think that's a big piece of negotiations. Women just have to understand their strengths.
Their strengths, yes. And in terms of the care, Nanette, what would you say would be the hesitation that you have noticed in working with your clients, with women?
I think that a lot of women are hesitant to take time for themselves or to care for themselves, and obviously guilt is huge. I think that as a whole, we do put ourselves at the bottom of the list, and it's very hard to move yourself to the top once you already accepted your spot.
Yes.
At the bottom.
Yes.
And I know one time we were doing a makeover segment. I think that you could probably relate to this also. During a makeover segment, and during the taping, the three women that were selected for the makeover were asked by the producer if they could just say a few words about themselves. And every woman answered exactly the same. I'm a wife, and my husband does X, Y, Z. I'm a mother, and my children do A, B, C. And I am sitting there biting my tongue. I don't want to be rude, but all I could think was, you know, today's your day. You were selected for this makeover because you were deserving of it. You know, you're going to be showcased on television. This is your day, your chance to shine. And what do you have to say that's special about you?
Our identity is kind of so tied up
to
being our, being a spouse and a mother.
And that's a hard thing to break away from.
Yes.
So I think that, you know, a lot of women do struggle with
sense of identity.
Yeah.
Yes, absolutely. Where we haven't really connected to who we really are on the inside as women, as me, you know, and everything is connected to what we do as women. Absolutely. Those are great. Those are really, really, really great tips. And for me, what I find as a lawyer turned corporate trainer and life coach and motivational speaker with working with my clients is the equipping part of the care. Because care is celebrate, applaud, refresh, and equip. You know, I work with a lot of, when it comes to the career, personal coaching, they're paying out of pocket. You know, and so, I find people, they're very hesitant in terms of investing in that, equipping themselves to advance in their career. I mean, one or two people have said to me, why do you put this on a Saturday, Princess Paula? If you made it on a Thursday, we could get our employers to pay, you know, for us to come and, you know, and they'll consider it as a professional training. But I'm saying to myself, okay, if your employer doesn't invest in your professional, it's your profession, it's your career. So you take control of that and, you know, invest in that. You know, and you map out your strategy, take control of your career, and you start networking, or you start attending these seminars, and you start reading the books and investing in your own, because it's yours. And I think it was Mallory that was pointing out, because that's the only ROI that's guaranteed. Okay? Yeah, it's the only one. You know, touch wood, we invest in our kids. We're hoping they turn out. You invest in the bloke, you don't know what happens after 17 years. He gets up one day and walks out of the door. So, that isn't guaranteed. And you're absolutely right. None of that is guaranteed. You say, I love you, I do. But 2 months later, you're, I don't do, I don't do, I don't do. And it walks away with everything. So, You know that when you invest in you, okay, and that you are going to get the return. And absolutely, we must begin to take control. It's about gaining control. And that's what I've found with a lot of my clients, working with my female clients especially. The blokes are really kind of, okay, you know, I want to make this happen. I'm in control. I'm navigating the ship of my life. I'm in the driver's seat. I know exactly where I want to go. But women somehow are very fatalistic and thinking somehow someone should do it for them or it would just happen. But it doesn't just happen. We have to take deliberate steps. And so part of that deliberate step is go to totalwomanconference.com and register for the third annual Total Woman Conference. I mean, already, I mean, you can feel the energy, can't you? Right at home with these women and the inspiration and the wisdom that is here. And these are just only maybe like half of all the speakers and the presentations and the things we have for you on Saturday, April 2nd. So do go to the website and register now. Now, what are the common mistakes that women make? You know, I was saying, you know, you want to review. They're so young. I know. They're, you know, I mean, these women are just so blessed. I know all combined experience over 100 years, but absolutely very young women. Sorry, books, all of them taken, except Mallory. Are you taken?
No.
No. So because I'm thinking some guys are thinking, wow, how hot, they're hot girls. Yes, we are. And smart too. But, you know, really and truly, you know, you look back over your career, you're talking about the young upcoming professionals, and that's also where my heart is with the conference I started last year. For the first time, very exciting for me. I partnered with St. Joseph's College, the Office of Diversity Initiatives, and we produced the first annual Total Woman Conference for girls and young women. And we had nearly 200 girls, age 12 up, you know, coming from schools and colleges in the area, because we want to start empowering them, want to catch them young, you know. We've had our own life stories and whatever, and we've made some of our mistakes. And is there anything, looking back, that you would say, you know, if you wanted to write a letter to your younger self, you would say that you would write and we would offer to a young woman who is watching this broadcast, because I'm going to play it for them when we're approaching the fall, is when we do the one for girls and young women. And so what would you say, a letter to your younger self, Lynn?
Well, I would say to mean what you say and say what you mean. And if I did that at an earlier age than when I did start doing that, I think things would have turned out differently.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And so is that being vocal, where you say no, you mean no, and you say yes, I mean yes. So it's kind of finding your voice earlier. Mm-hmm. Is that what you would say?
Yeah, and you know, when you're home and you're doing dishes and your husband or whatever's on the couch and you're really irritated that he's not helping, you need to say, come help me. You know, and it's just really, you know, believing in yourself and going forward.
Absolutely. I did a show with Janet at the end of the year, and we are looking back at 2010 on that show. And all these videos are available on demand at my website, royalproclamations.com, as well as whctv.org. You know, that video is still there. But, you know, we're looking back at the year and we're looking ahead into the new year, into this year. And one of the things, you know, we're saying, what has 2010 taught you and all of that? And, you know, what will you do differently in 2011? And one of the things I was saying to Janet at the time that 2010 taught me is that I learned to be more assertive. Mm-hmm. I learned to really, like you're saying, say, no, I don't like this. I don't appreciate this. No, I don't want. And that was really my personal relationship, you know. And so absolutely, finding your voice early, knowing your values from, you know, when you're young, and finding the courage to be able to say no, you know, and standing up for yourself and allowing yourself to respect yourself and also allowing, making sure others respect you. Absolutely. What's your letter to your younger self?
Three things come to mind. Challenge status quo.
Yes.
Be fearless.
Yes.
And, you know, simply don't be afraid to create big, audacious goals. I think people are
dream
so...
Dream big.
Dream big, yeah. People, I think, short themselves a lot in their life because of what they think other people will think and, you know, other people's opinion of, oh, you can't do that and, you know, no, you can never be a millionaire, you can never, you know, be a Hollywood actress, you know, whatever the case is. So they talk themselves out of pursuing great goals.
Yes.
And, you know, to me, you just look at great people and they're no different than us, you know, the Bill Gates and the Oprahs and everybody like that. So don't be afraid to dream big and then make small goals to get there. You know, almost do a 10-year plan and then work backwards.
Yes, I like that. Challenge the status quo. I mean, there's just so much wisdom. Are you taking notes? I'm like taking notes here, even in my brain. Yeah, the wisdom, you know, I need some of these principles that is being shared here today. And I know that you do too. And I know that you can look forward. I mean, we haven't even begun to scratch the surface of what awaits you at the Total Woman Conference on Saturday, April 2nd at the Simsbury Inn in Connecticut. We haven't even begun to, but this is like the tip of the iceberg of what's awaiting you. But just think of that wisdom. Yeah, challenge the status quo and dream big and just know that nothing is impossible, you know? And like I said, these women represent the possibilities. And even though they look like everyday women, which they are, very humble, but they're on top of their game professionally. And so, you know, you can be that woman and you can achieve it and you can do it if you believe it and dream it. And so what's your own letter to your younger self, Judy?
Two things. One, don't take yourself too seriously. And the other is own your success. Give yourself credit for what you have accomplished and not say, oh, anyone could do this or, oh, I could have done better. Own what you have accomplished. Own what you have done.
Exactly. And that's the whole care for you. Celebrate the uniqueness. Applaud the often over. And if there's no one to applaud you, like I said, hey, you know, give yourself a pat on the back and say, yeah, I've done a great job. And I mean, absolutely. I was saying to someone recently, you know, and I said, don't undermine what I've done. Look at what I've achieved as a woman of color, coming from not from this area, no network, no whatever, and all of that. I salute myself. So even if you don't salute me, you know I salute myself. It's not being braggadocious, but it's really kind of just owning and celebrating your own self and applauding yourself and knowing that you're doing a great job. Absolutely. And that's what the Total Woman Conference is all about. It's about celebrating the uniqueness of women, applauding the often overlooked. I mean, I think it's often overlooked, but we make great contributions to business, like Lynn, you know, through the work she does, the first woman in that position and doing a lot of great programs and things for women. I mean, and look at everybody else in here, you know, with a lot of achievements and contributions to family and to the community. And then, you know, refresh. Take time to refresh. Distress. and rejuvenate and get those spa treatments and everything else. You know, you just name it. It's a fabulous day. It's a fabulous facility. We deliberately this year listened to our attendees. They requested, last year we had it at the Connecticut Expo Center. And they said, no, take us somewhere we can really, truly feel refreshed and pampered. And so it's a 5-star hotel, the Simsbury Inn, very classic, very nice. And it includes the meal and everything. And then you equip yourself, you know, all spheres of life. We'll be talking spiritual, personal, you know, health and wellness. And, you know, we have panelists. And we've made it in a format that they requested for as well. They want to engage. And so what we decided, instead of having breakout sessions, is just have a panel of experts, and then they'll be engaging the audience and asking questions. So you can come with your questions, and we're doing one cool thing. We're very social media friendly this year, so you can tweet your questions. We have a social media moderator. So if you're watching, because this show is going to everywhere, it's going to be on Facebook, in China, in Africa. So you're watching us in wherever, Nigeria. And, you know, you're thinking, oh, how cool is that? I wish I could be there. Well, you may not be able to be there. Tweet in your question, you know, tweet in your question and we'll take your question. So we're going to be really global on Saturday, April 2nd. And for the VIP woman, request an invitation, totalwomanconference.com. We only have about 50 at the Blue Fox Run. Yeah, 50 spots. None left now. So you better hurry. Request for that invitation. And, you know, Blue, we're going to learn to play golf. You're going to get us the apparel. We're going to see and try and do some of these things the guys do. And no, guys, you're not invited. I know you're jealous, but no, you go to your own club next.
I think we should do a stayover Friday night at the end.
That's honestly, I think
pajama party.
Exactly. Actually, the Simsbury Inn is offering conference guests a huge discount on a hotel room. So if you want to give yourself that extra pampering, even why don't come the night before and just. You know, yes, absolutely. Just a real day girls retreat, and look at the dynamic women that you're going to be meeting and connecting with and all of that. Just women who are so inspirational and so unassuming and so with such a big heart, willing to give back, you know. So make it a date. It's time to care for you. We only have about a few more minutes, but what's your own letter to your younger self? What would you say? I mean, she has an amazing story. This woman has literally almost been homeless and, you know, been through a divorce where she had nothing and everything, has now built this huge business. She has over 125,000 people following her on Facebook, Twitter, social media.
And she has great accessories.
I know.
Thank you.
So, you know, everyone here, I mean, amazing, 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 amazing. So go register. So what's your letter quickly?
I'd say real quick, two things to myself.
Yes.
I would say that stay away from all dream squashers. Nothing hurts a great dream like a squasher. And my other piece of advice that I would give to myself is choose your mate. Be very selective.
Good.
Okay, there's lots of fish in the sea, so choose wisely.
Okay, absolutely. Don't settle. And yes, oh my God, it keeps coming back kind of to almost the same thing in terms of those toxic relationships.
Right.
Be very deliberate in who you surround yourself with, who's in your network, who's in your sphere of influence, who is speaking into your life, you know, who is inspiring you, you know. Be very deliberate about that. And I'm telling you, together we can go places. And the amazing thing that I'm seeing more and more women do these days that I didn't see before, you know, many times we used to be each other, you know, the B word, each other. We didn't want to support. A woman attains some level of success instead of pulling out the chair for her sister and say, hey, let me offer you, let me help you, girlfriend. She's very protective and, you know, it comes from some form of intimidation. But I'm seeing more and more that women are networking and more collaboration across all kinds of lines. I'm seeing that and it's very, very exciting to see. And you're going to see that at the Total Woman Conference on Saturday, April 2nd at the Simsbury Inn, 397 Up Meadow Street in Simsbury, Connecticut. Lastly, but not least, definitely, you know, that letter to your younger self. I know you have teenage children and all of that. So what would you say?
Well, I think one of the things is I wish that someone had said, don't worry so much. It's going to turn out okay.
Yes.
You know, I mean, especially women, we worry a lot.
Yes.
And it would be nice to say, you know, it's going to turn out. So you don't have to push it. But then on the other hand, life can be really short. And I've lived that, you know, having some, you know, relatives die at a young age. And so live your moment. I mean, don't waste time because it goes by. I mean, as we know, it zooms by as you get older. And you want to make sure every moment is really used to the maximum. Not to say you don't rest,
yes,
but that you rest with a purpose.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You've heard it. Saturday, April 2nd, 2011 at the Simsbury Inn, the third annual Total Woman Conference. The countdown has begun. You better rush and run to that website and register now so that you can guarantee and confirm your date with destiny. I promise you, our keynote speaker, oh my goodness, this woman's story will just simply blow your mind away, is Nadine Thompson. She's the CEO of Soul Purpose, and this is a direct selling company. She's in the top 30 in the industry all over the world. She has thousands of independent consultants who sell for her. It's an organic skincare product for women of color. And she's been on Oprah, Black Hand, award-winning entrepreneur, But yet, you know, like every woman in this room, very unassuming, her feet on the ground, very giving, very full of wisdom. I mean, you do not want to miss this conference, honestly, no joking. Saturday, April 2nd, 2011. And I want to appeal to employers. I know, you know, employers, even though it's a Saturday, some of us are employers here. Encourage your staff, invest, give them a treat. Care for them, you know, and tell them, you know, you want to come to this event. We have opportunity for you to exhibit. We're expecting close to 300 working women of diverse backgrounds. So, you know, that is the place you want to connect with women, you know, and women are, you know, have huge purchasing power. 80% of household purchasing decisions are made by women, as we know. So you want to get on that website, totalwomanconference.com. Either you want to come as a participant, as an exhibitor, as a sponsor, in whatever capacity you want to participate at the conference, you just go there right now before it's too late, because I'm telling you, this is a sold out event. It is so great to have you on here. I'm so truly honored that you're all involved in the conference in one way or the other. And that is part of the collaboration and the partnership as the queen of networking that I advocate. I practice what I preach. I met Lisa through a networking event, and she was sharing with me about Blue Fox Run. The next thing, I followed up, and here we are today. You know, the same, we're networking partners. And that's the philosophy by which I live. So come out. Get out of your house, out of your PJs. Yes, it's a Saturday. Get those rollers out of your head and put the laundry aside and, you know, and tell the kids, okay.
I'll see you later.
And the hobby or whoever. And tell your employer. Show this to your employer. Say, you know what? I'll be a better employee when I come back. And I'm sure they would really, because it is a professional development program. And so, really, that's all we have, 60 minutes up like that. Really, really great honor to be meeting you, Lynn, and I'm really excited. You're doing a phenomenal job. We truly admire the work that you're doing, and Lynn will be recognized at the Total Woman Conference, and Denise Merrill, on behalf of our state, is going to be recognizing her, as well as Deborah Allman of the YWCA and Miriam Torres, and presenting that well-deserved Woman of Distinction Award to Miss Lynn Ward. Thank you so much for being on Inspired Success. And Mallory is going to be there. Yes, she is. Ready to Total Woman Makeover. So, you know, Total Woman Makeover. Jody, obviously, is well going to be there. And she's going to producing and providing some of our products for us, the bags, the pens, and what a view. And Annette is there to speak about how you can grow Facebook and all the social media stuff, you know, which she's done so well of. And then Lisa is going to be there telling us a bit more about how we can be vocal, viable, visible, how we can negotiate, because this woman is negotiating at some level that some of us don't even kind of really can't envision or wrap our minds around. But she's going to give us some tools and strategies. So I am just so excited. I'm looking forward to meeting you there. When you come to the conference, look out for me. I will be speaking as well, and just say, you know, you're one of my viewers. Many times you always stop me in town and all about town and tell me how you're being inspired by this broadcast. I appreciate your feedback. We're on Facebook, we're on LinkedIn, we're on Twitter. Follow us, and I will see you on Saturday, April 2nd, 2011 at the Total Woman Conference at the Simsbury Inn in Simsbury, Connecticut. This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep learning. And to keep smiling. Hey, life's too short. Put a smile on your face. Come on. Keep networking. Keep believing. Keep on keeping on. I'll see you next month. It'll be spring. And we'll be springing alive. I'll be doing a really great show on, you know, remodeling, decorating, and how to really, truly spring alive. I'll see you next month. I want to thank you so much, ladies, for being here. Thank you so much. Thank you for your support of this noble vision. And thank you for your time today on the broadcast. God bless. I'll see you. Take care. Bye-bye.